One thing that we haven't mentioned very much is that there are a lot of cancers associated with increased insulin. Hyperinsulinemia and pancreatic cancer. This is a press release from the University of British Columbia. Some of their researchers and faculty just published an article in Cell Metabolism, August 2019. This is a picture of James Johnson in the Department of Cellular and Physiological Sciences. What they did was show much more of a, not an epidemiological study, but more of a clinical trial type study. They took some rats that couldn't make increased insulin and crossbred them with rats that did make increased insulin. What they found was, again, the offspring that couldn't make insulin were protected from pancreatic cancer. Now, why is that a big deal, and what does that mean in terms of humans? Well, we talk about insulin resistance quite a bit, but one of the things we forget is that hyperinsulinemia, increased insulin, goes right along with insulin resistance. We've talked about many times about how prevalent insulin resistance is. Again, hyperinsulinemia is just about as prevalent as insulin resistance. One thing that we haven't mentioned very much is that there are a lot of cancers associated with increased insulin. For example, breast cancer. Pancreatic cancer may have the strongest link. And again, these are all important cancers, things that we need to be focused on and thinking about in terms of, it's not just heart attack and stroke with insulin resistance. If you've made it this far, thank you for your interest. So I'm very excited to announce we now have a membership page. Now, what is that? That's the one place where you can go and access all of our digital products. It starts off with a few free things, like a lot of infographics, which help you understand the basics of insulin resistance, cardiovascular inflammation, and other key concepts on how to prevent heart attack and stroke. The next free item is the intro and first chapter of the book that we're writing on plaque. And the standards of medicine just aren't doing very well right now in terms of the number one killer and disabler, plaque. We don't do a good job of measuring it. We don't do a good job of monitoring it. And there are better ways. So that's what this book is all about. Again, go in and get a look at the intro and the first chapter. And if you've purchased the cardiovascular inflammation and IR courses, thank you so much for doing that. You purchased those at a time before we had them totally cleaned up, and we've cleaned them up now. And they're available for you right there on the membership page. Hit the link below, register, and go in and take a look. Look forward to seeing you there. Thank you.